Hello everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will demonstrate how to sign a document as a recipient in BoldSign. BoldSign is a modern, secure e-signature app to send documents out for legally binding signatures. It is not mandatory for signers to hold a BoldSign account to sign a document as recipients. When a signature request is created, recipients will be notified via email. Both BoldSign account holders and non-account holders can easily sign the document by clicking the link provided in that email. In addition, BoldSign account holders can initiate the signing process from the BoldSign web application too. They can locate the documents for signing in the Waiting for Me section of the BoldSign dashboard. Now, I will show how to sign a document from the signature request email. I am a non-BoldSign account holder and am proceeding to sign. First, I navigate to my inbox and locate the document that needs my signature. That email will display the sender's name, document title, expiration date, and a list of signers. I then click the Review and Sign button, which redirects me to the signing page. In the signing page, I must agree to the terms and conditions before signing the document. This includes the electronic signature disclosure terms and BoldSign's terms of use, which must be read and accepted before signing. On this page, there is also an option to change the language of the BoldSign application. Currently, there are 15 supported languages to choose from. I now select the checkbox and click the Continue button. You can access the available options by clicking the More Actions button at the top of the page. The available options include the download option to save the document to the local network. The reassign option lets you delegate the signing request to someone else. The decline option allows rejecting the signing request if you do not wish to sign the document. The shortcuts option provides quick access to frequently used actions. The save option allows you to save your progress on the document, and the view more information option gives additional details about the document. At the bottom left of the page, there are options to zoom in, zoom out, and fit the document to screen. After reading through the document, I click Start Signing, which will direct me to all the form fields that require completion. The document I am going to sign is a bike rental agreement. I sign here as a bike renter, and the rental company had sent it to get my signature. The name and email values will automatically populate, allowing me to begin filling out the remaining fields. I start filling the address and city fields, and then move to the next field by clicking the Next Field button at the top right corner. Next is a drop-down field for the state column, where I select New York. The entered state will be filled in the sync drop-downs as well. The subsequent fields are the zip code and driving license number text boxes, which I fill based on the validation criteria and then proceed. Next, I pick the start and end rental dates from the date picker field and select them. The next field is a yes or no question requiring a radio button selection. As my license has not been suspended, I select the no option. If I select yes, a text box appears next to the reason column, where I should include the reason for the suspension. I am required to attach my driving license in the following field. It can be attached in a PDF, Word or image, and the size limit for the attachment is up to 25 megabytes. I attach my license here and scroll to the bottom of the page and add my signature by clicking the signature field. The signature can be chosen from an auto-generated design, drawn digitally, or uploaded as an image. By enabling the Apply Everywhere option, your signature will be automatically applied to all signature fields in the document. I select an auto-generated design here. When the document opens for my signature, the date sign field automatically gets filled. After all form fields are filled, I review the document once and click the Complete Signing button. The document is signed successfully now. In my case, since I am the only signer, I will now receive the completed document through email. However, if the document contains more than one signer, the completed document will be received through email only when all the signers have completed signing. In addition, if I am a BoldSign account holder, I can also download the document from the My Documents page within the BoldSign application anytime. Since I am not a BoldSign account holder, a message is displayed prompting me to create a free BoldSign account. It is not compulsory to sign up, but you can access the BoldSign web application by creating a free account to view the document's entire metadata and manage it. The completion email contains both the final document and the audit trail document as attachments. If you found this video helpful, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more BoldSign tutorial videos.